Greetings, humans. I'm Dale, and in today's tutorial, I just wanted to go through a few different tips and tricks and things within Photoshop that I use to help kind of change the perception of an image and add more depth. So changing the way that a viewer looks at an image, so the eye kind of goes through to areas that you want them to look at. So yeah, let's do it. The image that we're working on today was taken in the Fiordland National Park. Had a fun little time walking around rainforests and getting wet and all that kind of stuff. So yeah, let's jump into it. So the first one is kind of a darken and mask. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a new layer. We're going to fill it with black. So on the left-hand side here, just making sure the background color is black or a variation of it. Let's go straight black for the moment. I'm going to go Command or Control Delete just to fill that layer with that black. And then I'm going to change the layer mode to soft light. And then the opacity, I'll leave the opacity at the moment. And I'll apply a layer mask. So just a very touchy thing with the layer mask. The best way that I kind of remember it is white reveals, black conceals. So if you see white there on the right hand side, it's showing everything. Whereas if I invert that and it's black, it's showing nothing. Nothing supplied. So what we're going to do is we're going to invert that again so it's white. B for brush. And then we're going to make that brush little bit bigger, and then I'm just going to kind of focus on the area that I want people to look at. So just through there, making sure the opacity is at 100%, little bit of a feather on it, and I'm just going through, just kind of like clicking roughly in this area where I want the focus to be between the two trees. Okay, cool. So that's pretty good. So you can be as finicky with this as you want, but just for the moment, just kind of roughly going through there. Now, doesn't look very good at the moment, but I'm going to change the opacity down to something like 20%. So it's a little bit more subtle, but it's there. So let me turn it off and then on, off, on. Essentially what we're doing is we're just kind of darkening around the edges there. So that's one little technique there. Let's delete that. The next one is going to be removing contrast. And we're going to do that by using an Orton effect. So a Command or Control J to duplicate that layer. I'm going to go up here into Filter, Blur, Gaussian Blur. In terms of the radius, it depends on a few things, but my kind of rough is the megapixels of your camera. So I've got a Z6II and has a 24.5 megapixel BSI sensor in it. So I'm just going to go 25. You can do whatever you want. You can play around with it, but that's my general rule. And then what we're going to do is we're going to change the layer mode to probably, let's try overlay. And we're going to bring that down to 20%. Yeah, let's make it normal. So normal with 20%, looking like this, it looks crap at the moment. But let's apply that layer mask. So white reveals, black conceals. So we're just going to invert it just so it doesn't show it. B for brush, going to make that brush big. And the opposite of before, we're going to kind of click in where we want there to be not as much focus. So we're going to go X to switch these across here. Just clicking through, just roughly going through the edges where we don't want the focus to necessarily be. And we'll probably bring that down to maybe 10%. So turn that off and on. And you can see here, right in the corner, it just kind of gets rid of that little bit of contrast there and helps kind of bring the eyes through. Now the next thing we're gonna do is we're gonna do some saturation dodging and burning, I guess. So the eye goes from kind of passively goes from darkness to light. It goes from cool to warm, and it also goes from less saturated to saturated. So what we're going to do is we're going to use that kind of concept to help push that eye through the frame a little bit. So let's get rid of that layer there. I'm going to create a new layer. I'm going to go B for brush. We're going to change the layer mode to saturation. And then here, we're going to make it, we'll make it like a gray. Yeah, we'll make it a gray color. And that's just kind of getting rid of the saturation. In terms of the brush, let's bring that hardness all the way down. And then brushing down a little bit more. Now, what I find helpful with this is you go at an opacity of something like 100%. So you know exactly where you're applying that adjustment, and then you kind of pull back the opacity of the layer itself. So I'm just going to go through and work out where I kind of want to get rid of it, and then we'll pull that back. So probably here in the foreground. So I noticed that that fern kind of there towards the front is a little bit more saturated, probably up there in the corner, probably up here as well. Maybe that little stick that's sticking out there a little bit. This little bit here, here. Maybe that stick under there, and maybe that stick just there. Okay, cool. Doesn't look very good at the moment, but that's okay. We're going to bring the opacity down to maybe 20%. So that's it without. That's it with. So you can see here, especially when I zoom in, without, with. It's just kind of getting rid of that saturation in the fern, so your eyes kind of help go through the frame a little bit more. Now the next thing is kind of helping people understand the three-dimensionality of an image. So one of the best ways to do that is dodging. So what we're going to do is we're going to go, okay, cool, the light is coming from, where are we? The light is essentially coming from here, and it's coming out like so. What's it hitting, and how can we help accentuate that? So let's get rid of that. And the best way of doing that is to do a little bit of dodging and burning. Now, I usually use something like the Rapid Mask, the TK panel, to create a luminosity mask. But in this case, just in case you don't have it, let's just jump to the channels here. So it's a similar concept to the masking from before. So white reveals, black conceals. Essentially what's happening here is you've got the different channels or different color channels of an image, you know, red, green, blue. You know, if you combine those, then you end up with an image that looks like that. But what we can do is we can go through and work out what channels we want to use to help mask. So having a look at the red, green, blue. Generally, it's going to be the red. So you can see here, there's a little bit more kind of contrast and white up there. Let's have a look at the green. Nah. Blue. Nah. So yeah, let's go with the red. So I'm going to hold down Command and click on that. You can see you've got little marching ants and stuff like that. Essentially what that's done is it's just created a selection, a mask selection of that. Then we're going to go back to our layers. We're going to create a new layer. I'll just get rid of those. Delete the sector of the layers. Yep, there we go. And then I'm going to apply the layer mask to it. So essentially what you've done is you've jumped in the channels, gone, hey, I like red, awesome. I'm going to select that red channel. I'm going to select the luminosity values and stuff in there, and then you're going to apply it to the layer. So clicking that there. And then you can see here in this little thing that has actually applied it. So we're going to go back to the normal mode. Go back to the layer, select normal. I'm going to change that to overlay. So B for brush. And then we're not going to make it red. We're going to select a color that's up here. going to shift it a little bit towards yellow and a little bit towards that white as well. So B, I'm just using the brackets to make it bigger and smaller. And then we're going to go through and do a little bit of dodging. So as with before, 100% everything, and then pull it back. So I'm just getting the edges of things. And essentially what's happening with this luminosity mask is it's doing a lot of the heavy lifting. So it's not applying the dodging and stuff that you're doing to the darks. So for example, if I go over the darks, see how it doesn't kind of apply it globally? Whereas let's say I don't do that. Let's say I do an overlay with just, we'll turn off the layer underneath and do that across. See how it's kind of globally applying it everywhere? It's because you don't have the little white reveals, black conceals over an entire image. Whereas with this one, it's a little bit more subtle, which is kind of what we want going on. So just kind of think about where the light's going. It's kind of coming out there, it's hitting things, and then you're just going through the edges. Generally what will happen is the mask will kind of pick up those edges anyway, and it just kind of helps us accentuate it a little bit more. So I'm just going through, clicking. Maybe we can go down here into the leaves a little bit more. You can make modifications to this, you know, you can change the opacity, all that kind of stuff, but I'm just kind of going all out just to kind of give a rough example of what's going on there. Okay, cool. So let's have a look at the image as a whole. So that's with it off, that's with it on, off, on. And then as I said before, you're changing that opacity down so it's a little bit more subtle, and it kind of helps bring the eye in there. Each of those kind of little techniques help a lot, and they all kind of add up, so you can kind of mix and match and put them all together. Now there is, because good things generally come in fives, there is one other technique that I have as well. So we can essentially use the same concept pretty much, but this time we'll delete that. We're going to, so we'll select, I'll use the same color that I used before. I'm gonna go big, 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 big. I'm gonna click once at 100%, bang. And then that's obviously with the hardness down, the size kind of as big as it goes. And then we're going to change the mode to probably, let's try screen. There we go. Now that's applying absolutely everywhere, which is not what we want. We want it to be more subtle than that. Otherwise it just becomes a distraction. So we're going to go back into the channels. We're going to select the red again. So clicking on the red, holding down Command or Control, that's going to apply it. You get the little marching ants. We're going to go back into the layers, and then we're going to apply that layer mask to it. There we go. Maybe let's just go through here. You can kind of work out what looks best. Thankfully it does give you a preview when you're kind of over the top of these. For the sake of time, I'm not going to mess around. Let's go overlay, and then we're going to bring the opacity of that down a little bit. So you can see there, when I toggle it off and on, essentially what you've got is you've got a gradient or a brush, but it's only getting applied to the light parts of the image. So that's a before, that's an after, and each of these little things kind of help add up to something that
ends up looking the way that you want it to. And each of those little things, for me personally, I find helps draw the eye in.
I hope that was helpful. I hope you got something out of it. Let me know in the comments if you did. And as always, like, subscribe, all those good things. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye.